Okay, now we are going to start the class. Okay, today's class, we are going to discuss about the functions. C language functions. In the yesterday's class, we are discussing about the file handling. And today's class, we are going to discuss about the functions here. Inside the C language, which type of things we are going to be called it as a functions. And here function means what? Suppose if your function is nothing but what? To divide the, to divide a huge task into the, to solve a big problem means we are dividing that problem and dividing that problem into small problems and solving individually, and at last we are going to combine that problem means combining that problem means we are going to be called it as what? Divide and conquer. Like that inside the software engineering, which type of scenario we are going to be called it as a designing structured programs. Designing structured programs means what? Here what is the inside the software engineering, for which type of scenario we are going to use this designing structured programs means to construct a program in efficient, concerned manner means we are going to use something concept called about functions in C language. And what is the other type of thing we are going to be called it as means robust. Robust means what? The program itself is solving its problems means we are going to be called it as what? The program itself is solving it, the problems without the help of the developers means we are going to be called it as what? Robust. And in which type of scenario we want to develop the programs means in robust manner as well as in which manner means reliable manner. Reliable nothing but what? Whatever the project we have developed, the project to be worked for a long period of time without any problems means we are going to be called it as what? Reliable. And here what is the in real time scenario, what is the concept is similar to this programming. Suppose if you are constructing a building, then what are the things are needed in the initial stage? You are going to design one plan. Based on that plan, we are going to be called it as what? Blueprint. And depending on that plan only, we are going to construct the house. That plan is going to have some solutions. By depending on those solutions only, we are going to construct the house. And why we are going to follow that plan means to minimize the what? To minimize the risks to be faced while constructing the house. And inside the while constructing the house, some of the materials are being available ready made. Some of the things are going to be newly built. And already ready made type things we are going to be called it as what? Already solved problems. And newly defining problems we are going to be called it as what? Those problems previously has not been solved. Now we are going to solve, we are going to write a new solution to that particular problem means we are going to be called it as what? Newly solving problems. And here inside the same type of scenario we are going to be followed inside the what? Designing structured programs. And here what is the first thing we are having? It is this approach is going to follow some four things. What is the thing it is having? To solve a large problem means what is the thing it is going to be followed? Break the problem into the what? Several pieces and work on each piece separately. Works on what? Each piece separately. Suppose if you are developing a calculator problem, if you are developing a calculator project, and here one was there are five people are working on that calculator project. The five people are going to divide that problem into the what individually. One developer is going to write the code for the what addition of two numbers, addition module. One programmer is going to write the code for the what subtraction, and one programmer is going to write the code for the what division. And after solving those problems individually, they are going to combine the problem, and that combined problem we are going to be called it as what a large problem. We are going to be called it as what a large problem. And inside the designing structured programming approach, and how a large problem is going to be divided it into the small problems, and how it is going to be solved separately. Here, what is the first statement we are having? To solve the large problem means break the problem into the what several pieces and work on each piece separately. And next, what is the to solve each piece means what is the thing they are meeting? Treat it as a what a new problem that can it be broken down into the what a smaller problems. Those pieces we are going to be called it as what a smaller problems. And here that process is going to be repeated until the problem has been solved. Until the problem has been solved accurately, the process is going to be repeated. Repeat the process with each new piece until each can be solved directly without further decomposition. Inside the future, suppose you have developed a project. What is the criteria we need to be followed means we need to follow something as what inside that project no drawbacks should be existed while releasing the project. Such type of projects the people are not going to be used. So what is the thing we need to develop a project for a long life without any problems means we need to process it repeatedly. Whether it is working properly or not, we are going to be checked. And such type of concept we are going to be called it as what designing structured programs. And this is the theoretical information. This is the theoretical information for what? This is the theoretical information for what? Theoretical information about the what? C functions. Now we are going to discuss programmatically. And inside this C functions, what are the two types of functions we are having? Two types of functions we are going to have what? If the user is creating the function means those functions we are going to be called it as what? User defined. And some of the functions we are going to be called it as what? Standard library functions. Already the C developers has been developed those functions. Just we are going to use those functions in our program means those functions we are going to be called it as what? Predefined or standard library functions. What are the two types of functions we are going to have? We are going to have two types of functions as what user defined and other type as what standard library functions. And why the functions are used in the program? Now we are going to learn inside these functions. We are going to learn why these functions are going to be used in programming inside the C programming. Why the people are going to refer these C functions here? And here, what is the suppose? The people has given a specific task. Inside the task, we are having something as what? Create a circle and color it. Creating a circle, we are dividing it as one task. And creating a color, we are dividing it as one task. And like this, we are going to divide the complex problem into the what? Smaller tasks. And our programmer program easy to understand and reuse. Suppose inside the vehicle there is a car. Inside that car we are going to have several parts. Suppose if the horn is not working means you are going to check at which part means you are going to check at the horn motor. You are going to check the horn motor directly. Why we are not going to check if the horn is not working, means we are going to check the wheels, or we are going to check the horn. We are going to check the horn itself. Like that, suppose in the inside the program, any problem is existed, means that problem is related to which type of functionality, it is going to be identified easily. It is going to be identified easily. That's why we are going to develop the program in a which format, means structured based programming format. We are going to develop the program in C language. How we are going to be developed him is structured based format. And here, that's why our program is easy to understand. And what is the other thing we are having? Reuse. Suppose the same type of functionality is needed in other program, means we are just going to import this functionality to that program here. And this is the main advantage we are going to have by using the functions. What is the advantage we are going to have, means reusability is going to be advantage. That's why we are going to use that function inside the other programs also. And here, what are the types of functions we are having here, means standard library functions. And what is the one more type of function we are having, means user defined function. Just now we have discussed standard library functions means what? In the last classes, in the last class programs, we have used something as what? Printf function. To display the output state, to display any information, means what is the functionality we have been using? Printf. That printf function, we are going to be called it as what? Built-in function to support. Suppose if we want to use this function, means what is the header file we are going to be included in our program? We are going to include something as what? stdio.h. Why? Because if you are not including this statement, means this printf function is not going to be supported. Suppose if you want to use a mathematical function called square root function, and then what is the header file we are going to be included? There is no need to write the code. There is no need to write the logic once again for the what? Square root. Already the C developers has written the code for the square root. Just in our program, what is the header file we are going to be included here, means we are going to include hash include math.h, and we are going to find out as what? Square root of 9. It is going to give the result as what? 3. For this, we are not going to write the logic, and C developers has already been written the logic, and where that logic is existed means inside a header file called math.h. And this type of functions we are going to be called it as what? Standard library functions. Where those standard library functions are going to be stored means inside the which files they are going to be stored. They are going to be stored inside the functions, inside the header files called, inside the header files those functions are going to be stored. And to use those functions means we need to include header file, and whatever the header file is related to that function, that header file we need to be included, and we need to use that particular function. And this is all about what these printf function, square root function, scanf function, cos function, all these functions we are going to be called it as what? Built-in functions. And now what is the user defined function? How we are going to create our user defined functions? User defined functions are nothing but whatever the functions created by us, we are going to be called it as what? User defined functions. The functions which has been created by user, we are going to be called it as what? User defined. And here we are having one structure. Example structure. Till now we have written the code inside the which function here, means inside the main method we have been written. Suppose here red color lines are indicating something as what? This particular line is indicating from here to here, it is indicating something as what? One user defined function. user defined function. And here we are writing something as what a user defined function. And how we are going to use this function means, this particular part we are going to be called it as what a function definition and function. Okay, function definition we are going to be called. And we are going to be called it as what a function definition. Why we are going to be called it as a definition means, here we are defining inside the opening and closing block, we are defining the code. We are defining the code for the what a function name. And suppose if we want to use this function means, from the main method we need to make the call. And this type of statement we are going to be called it as what a function call. We are going to be called it as what a function call or calling a function. Whenever we are calling the function means, here there is no need to indicate opening and closing block. Just we need to indicate something as what a semicolon. We need to indicate it as what a semicolon. This type of statement we are going to be called it as what a calling a function. And if we call the function means, it is going to move here and it is going to execute from here to here. After execution, it is going to move to the what a this line. It is going to move to the this line. This type of scenario we are going to be called it as what here inside this what is the how the user defined function is going to be worked. This statement we are going to be called it as what a function call, and this statement we are going to be called it as what a function definition. And suppose if we want to invoke that function means, how we are going to be, we need to indicate a statement called a function call. And whenever we are invoking this means, it is going to move here and it is going to execute from this opening to closing. After closing, it is going to move to the what next line of this function call statement. And in this manner, it is going to execute something as what user defined functions. And here, what is the how the user defined function? The same thing, whatever the thing I have explained here, here it is mentioning it as theoretically. And here, what is the here? Clearly they are showing something as what arrow marks. If the function is calling means, where it is moving, it is moving to the what open block, and it is starting from here and it is ending here. After end, it is moving to the what next line. This is the diagram which is showing how the function is going to be worked. And here function names are also being indicated it as what function names are also being indicated it as what function names are nothing but what identifiers. We need to assign something as what name as what unique name. And suppose inside the program we are having two functions, and for the both the functions we cannot give the what same name. We need to maintain something as what unique name. And for function names are indicated it as what function names are nothing but what identifiers. Like variables, the functions are also being called as what variable names also we are going to be called it as identifiers. Like that, function names are also being called as what identifiers. And okay, what are the advantages are there by using the user defined functions here? Easier to understand and maintain, debug. Just now we have discussed one car example. Inside the car, if the horn is not working means, directly you are going to move to the wire. You are going to move to the horn motor and you are going to check whether the horn motor is working or not. You are not going to move to the what other motors. You are going to directly move to the what horn motor. Why? Because horn is not working. That's why if you develop the code by using the what user defined function means, what is the thing is easier means, it is easier to understand and what maintain, and it is easier to what debug. And what is the main advantage we are having by using the user defined function means, reusability. What is the main advantage we are having here means, reusability. And what is the one more advantage we are having here? A large program is divided it into the smaller modules, and a large project can be divided among the what many programmers. And inside the project, a single project is not going to be done by a single person. It can be done by multiple people. If that project, how that project is going to be divided means depending on the what modules. One person is going to develop the addition module, one person is going to develop the subtraction module, one person is going to develop the what division module. Like that, the project is going to be divided. This is the advantage we are going to have by using the what user defined functions. And here, what is the what a function means for here, a large program is divided into the basic building blocks. Generally, you are going to play something as what you are going to construct some house house by using some toys called building blocks here. Like that, here also the program is going to be constructed in which manner means the large program into the what basic building blocks. And here, where the function is going to be opened and closed here means function opening and closing purpose, we are going to use something as opening braces and closing braces. And inside here, how many times that function is going to be called means we can call for multiple times also. We can call that function for 100 times. What is the advantage we are having here means if you are not creating the function means you are going to write that code for the what multiple number of times, and there is no need to write for the multiple number of times. Only single time we can write, but we can use for it. We can use it for what multiple times, and such type of scenario we are going to be called it as what reusability, and we are going to be called it as what modularity, and. These functions we are going to be called it as what procedures and subroutines. The people are going to call the other name of the functions as what inside the exam explain about procedures means you need to explain about the what functions itself. Explain about subroutines also means you need to explain about the what functions itself. And this is the general information about the what functions. And what are the advantages we are having by using the functions means avoid what rewriting the same logic code again and again. And save functions any number of times we can call. We can call the function any number of times. We can call C functions for any number of times. We can track a large C program easily. We can track, suppose if you want to if you are developing a robot. That robot is containing hands, legs, brain. Suppose if you want to modify the brain means you are going to move to the what brain module. If you want to modify the code for the legs means you are going to move to the what legs module. Like that, we can track a large C program easily. Why it is easy means we have divided it into the what multiple functions. And reusability is the main achievement, and function calls is always a overhead inside the what C program. And what are the aspects we are having while declaring the, now we are going to see one example program and which type of thing we are going to be called it as a function declaration, and which type of thing we are going to be called it as a function call, and which type of thing we are going to be called it as a function definition. And here we are having one syntax. Function declaration means what is the thing we are indicating. Function declaration means return type, function name, argument list. And a function call means what is the thing we are indicating. Here we are not indicating return type. Here we are indicating the function name and arguments list. We are passing the values, and we are keeping some semicolon. And this type of statement we are going to be called it as what a function call. And function definition means what return type, function name, argument list, opening block, closing block. Inside that block we are going to write the what code. We are going to write the what code. And such type of thing we are going to be called it as what a function definition. And now we are going to see these things practically by using the what program. Which type of thing we are going to be called it as function declaration, which type of thing we are going to be called it as a function call, and which type of thing we are going to be called it as a function definition. And now we are going to see practically here. And here, okay. Here, what is the this type of statement? Generally, inside the program, how you are going to declare the variables means like this, you are going to declare int a, like this, you are going to declare the variable. And here, what is the how we are going to declare the function? Function declaration means before the main method, we are going to declare the function declaration as what? Here, function prototype, we are indicating it as what? Here, function. What is the first time we are first thing we are having? Function declaration means what is the first thing we are having? Return type. And here, what is the return type we are having here? Means here we are having something as what? Void. And after that, what is the thing we are indicating? Function name. And here we are indicating the function name as what? Here we are indicating the function name as what? Hello. And inside the curve braces, here we have passed any arguments or not passed? Here we have not passed any arguments. It is a parameterless function. It is a parameterless function. And this type of statement we are going to be called it as what? Function declaration. We are going to be called it as what? Function declaration. And which type of statement we are going to be called it as a function call means? Here we are going to call it as what? A function call. Here we are calling the function. Whenever we are calling hello, and here there is no need to mention any prototype, directly this function name and parameter list and a semicolon we are going to be indicated. And whenever we are calling means it is going to move here. Why? Because we have written the code inside this. And this type of statements we are going to be called it as what? This type of statements we are going to be called it as what? Function calls. We are going to be called it as what? Function calls. And this type of statement we are going to be, these three lines we are going to be called it as what? These 11th line to 13th line we are going to be called it as what? Function definition. We are writing the code for this hello. We are writing the code for this function. And by using some opening block and a closing block. And opening block and a closing block. And this type of thing we are going to be called it as what? A function definition. And in this manner, we are going to create something as what? Functions. And here, what is the which type of function we have been created? And which type of function we have been created? There are two types of functions we are going to have. And return value without return value. What are the two types of functions we are going to have here means return value and non-return value. Return value means what? Before the function, if we are declaring int. Before the function, if we are declaring int means what is the inside the opening and closing brace? What is the thing we need to be used? Return statement we need to be used. That return value it is going to return. What is the value it has to be written? Integer value it has to be written. And such type of function we are going to be called it as what? Return based. And which type of thing we are going to be called it as without return value means if we are inside the opening and closing brace. If we are not using a return statement, if we are not using return return statement, if it is not returning any value, means we are going to indicate that function prototype as what? That function prototype as what? Void. That function prototype as what? Void we are going to be indicated. We are going to indicate it as what? Void. And here, what is the first example program we are having here means example program as what? Without return value. And here we have declared the function without return value. And if I executed this program, how many times it is going to display? Here it has been called hello for first time, second time, third time. This program is going to display hello C for how many times here means? Three times it is going to be displayed. We have used this function for how many times we have been used? we have been used this function for how many times? We have been used this function for 3 times here. And here, if I am executing this program, and here I am compiling and executing. And how many times it is going to be executed here means, okay, how many times it is going to be executed here means, 3 times it is going to be displayed. Why? Because we have called this function for how many times? 3 times. That's why it is displaying something. How many times it is displaying? Hello C for this function. And the second line it is displaying for this function. And the third line it is displaying for this statement. And in this type of scenario, we are going to be called it as what? Before the function, we are having void means we are going to be called it as what? Without return type. We are going to be called it as what? Without return value. Why? Because inside the opening and closing, what is the statement we have not been used? Return statement we have been not been used. And here, before the main method, we are using int. That's why we are using something as what? What is the statement we are using? RETURN. Return statement we are using. And here, the second example, which is explaining about the what? Return statement. If the method is containing some return statement, then what are the, how we are going to be accessed? If the method is containing some return statement, then how we are going to be accessed? And here, what is the, inside the function declaration, we have indicated the getX function prototype as what? Int. And getY function prototype as what? Double. And how we are going to access? We are not going to access it directly. And here, int getX means what is the prototype value it is having? Prototype is what? Int. And it is returning some value as what? What is the value it is returning here means? 10 it is returning. That's why we are assigning this while function calling, we are assigning that function to the what? Which variable we are assigning? To which variable we are assigning here means int x. Int x is equal to get x of. What is the value is going to be assigned indirectly here means? This function is going to return some value as what? 10. This function is returning some value as 10. The 10 is going to be assigned to the what? The 10 is going to be assigned to the what? X. In this manner, we are going to access something as what? Return functions. Some people are going to access directly. How the people are going to access directly from the which statement? Access directly from the which statement they are going to be accessing by inside the what? Printf statement. And here, what is the value it is displaying inside the printf? What is the y is equal to? What is the value we are displaying? Percentage f nothing but what? Floating point. Percentage f nothing but what? Floating point. And here we are displaying. And here, whatever, what is the value? 12.34. That return value is going to be displayed. Y is equal to what? 12.34. And here, we are accessing directly. We are not, we are writing in a shortcut manner. And here we are writing in an, we are assigning the returning value to the X. And after that, we are displaying the value as what? X. And this type of functions, we are going to be called it as what? Function with what? Function with return value. Here, getX function is having the which return value? The getX function is having return value as what? Integer. And getY function is having the return value as what? Double. The getY function is having the return value as what? Double. Why we are indicating it as a double means? The return value is of which type? Floating point type. And why we are indicating the return value as integer means? Here we are indicating the, it is returning the value as what? Integer value. That's why we have declared it as what? While defining the function, we declare the prototype as what? Int. This is all about the what? Function with return values. And if I execute this program, and if I execute this program means, what is the output we are going to be expected? X is equal to, what is the value it has to be written? 10. And Y is equal to, what is the value it has to be written? 12.34. And here I am compiling and executing the program. And what is the value it is going to be displayed? And x is equal to what is the value? 10. And y is equal to what is the value? 12.34. Double value it is returning. And this value has been displayed by using this statement. And this 10 value has been stored inside the x, and by using the x we are displaying something as what a 10 value. And this is all about function with a return statement, function with a return value. And previously we have discussed something as what a function without a return value, function without a return value. And now I think all of you understood about the function with the return values and function without return values. And what are the different types of aspects are there while calling the functions? What are the different types of aspects are there while calling the function? And here you need to remember something as what four aspects you need to be remember. What are the four aspects we need to be remember? And this is the concept is going to explain about the water. Just now we have discussed about the water. What are the concepts we have been discussed? Designing structured programs and declaring functions and signature of the function parameters and here means without arguments with return value. What is the first thing we need to be remember? Without arguments without a return value. Without arguments without a return value. And a second scenario we need to remember it as what? Without arguments with a return value. Without arguments with a return value means what? And third, with arguments without a return value. With arguments, to the function we are passing some arguments and that function is not returning any value, not returning the value, it is displaying the value by using function statements itself. And fourth scenario as what? With arguments with return value. What are the four scenarios you need to be remember for to explain about the passing parameters to the functions means you need to remember something as what? Without arguments without return value, without arguments with return value, with arguments without return value, and with arguments with return value. These are the four scenarios you need to be remember. And now we are going to see which type of scenario we are going to be called it as what? Without arguments without return value here. Without arguments without return value we are going to be seeing. And which type of scenario we are going to be called it as without arguments what is the scenario name? Without arguments without a return value. And here we are going to discuss here what is the scenario name? Without arguments without a return value, without arguments and without return value. Then here we are not mentioning any return type. Empty return type means we are going to be indicated it as what? We are going to be indicated it as what? Void. We are going to be indicated it as what? Void. That's why we are indicated it as what? Without return value. And arguments means here we inside this we have indicated any int like this we have indicated. We have not indicated. We have left it as empty. That's why we are calling it as what? We are calling it as what? Without arguments. We are calling it as what? Without arguments. And here it is a program about the what? Addition of two numbers. And whenever I am calling the sum means it is this function is going to invoke inside this. What is the statement? It is going to be executed. Enter two numbers. And from the user, it is taking some value as what? Collecting the values of A and B. And after that, it is displaying the value as what? The sum is A plus B, it is displayed. And this type of defining the statement, this type of defining this statement we are going to be called it as what? Function without return type, function without arguments, function without arguments, and function without return type. This type of scenario, this type of aspect, we are going to be called it as what? Function without arguments and function without return type. And if I execute this program, if I execute this program, means what is the output it is going to be displayed? If I execute this program, means what is the output it is going to be displayed here? Means here I am closing this. And if I am executing this program, what is the output it is going to be displayed? First of all, it is going to display going to collect, calculate the sum of two numbers. Going to calculate the sum of two numbers. After that, it is invoking a function called sum function. It is going to be invoked. It is going to invoke a function called sum. Inside that, what is the statement it is executing? Enter two numbers. Enter two numbers. And now I have given some two numbers as what? 10, 20. And the 10 and 20 is going to be stored inside the what? 10 is going to stored in A and 20 is going to be stored in B. The sum is percentage T. A plus B means what is the value it is going to be written. The sum is what is the value it is returning? 30. And this type of aspect we are going to be called it as what? Function without return type. Function without what? Without arguments. Function without return type and function without what? Arguments. And what is the second type of aspect we are having? Second type of aspect as what? Without arguments. But what is the thing we are having? With the return value. Without arguments, with the return value. And here next example we are going to see. And here what is the statement we are having here means function is containing what is the return statement it is containing? Int. So we are calling it as what? Function with the return value. But what is the thing it is not having? Here we are not passing any arguments. Here we are not passing any arguments. And this type of scenario we are going to be called it as what? Without arguments but with the return value. And here what is the sum value? We are the sum function is assigned to the which one? Result variable. And we are displaying the result here. And what is the value it is returning? It is returning something as this function is returning the output. This function is returning the value of AB as what? Return A plus B. That result it is going to be stored inside the what? That result is going to be after completion of execution. That result value is going to be assigned to the which variable? Result variable. And after that, if you are displaying means, it is going to display the result. And this type of definition we are going to be called it as what? Function without arguments, function without parameters, or function without arguments, but function with what? Return statement. Function with what? Return statement. Return statement or function with what? Prototype. And here if we execute this program, then what is the, in the previous, whatever the output it has been displayed, the same type of output it is going to be displayed. But here inside this scenario, what is the statement we have been used? Return statement we have been used, 10, 20, and it is displaying something as what? 30. And after executing this statement, it is going to execute this statement. Inside this statement, what is the statement is going to be invoked first? It is going to invoke some function. It is going to be invoked and it is going to execute entire two numbers. And after that, it is collecting the two variables. And after that, it is returning two values. Return 10 plus 20 means what is the that result it is going to be stored inside the result, and it is displaying the value as what? 30. And this type of scenario we are calling it as what? Function without arguments and function with what? Return statement. Function without arguments, function without arguments, and function with what? Return statement. Function with return value. And this is the second scenario. And what is the third scenario we are having? And here we are going to pass the parameters, and those parameters we are calling it as arguments, function with arguments and function without return value. Function with arguments and function without return value. Function without a return value. And here what is the next example we are going to be seen here means function with arguments and function without a return value. And here what is the while defining the function means what is the function declaration, how we have been indicated, how many arguments it is containing? Two arguments. First argument is of which type? Integer type. Second argument is of which type? Integer type. And what is the function prototype? Void. Void means what? Non-return type. Void means what? Non-return type. And here inside this program, while calling the function, what is the thing we are indicating? Here we are passing first argument as what? A. And second argument as what? B. This A is going to be copied into the what? A. And this B is going to be copied into the what? B. This A is going to be copied into the where? A. And B value is going to be copied into the what? B. And here the sum of the sum is percentage D means it is going to calculate A plus B means the value is going to be calculated. And here itself we are displaying. So the value is going to return it as what? 10 plus 20 means A value is 10 and B value is 20 means it is going to return, it is going to display it as what? The sum is what? 30. And this type of scenario we are going to be called it as what? Function without a return type, but function with what? Arguments. Function with what? Arguments. Function with arguments. And if we execute this program means it is going to display the same kind of output it is going to be displayed. It is going to display the same kind of output. And here I am giving something as what? 10, 20. And it is giving something as what? 30. Here entire two numbers is executed from main method or sum function. Entire two numbers statement is executed from the what? Main method. And where A and B values has been collected inside from the main method, the A and B values has been collected. And where the result statement, the sum is 30 is displaying means the sum is 30 is displaying from the which functionality? Sum functionality it is displaying. It is displaying from the what? Sum functionality. And this type of scenario we are going to be called it as what? Function with arguments and a function without what? Return type. Function with arguments. Function with arguments. Without what? Return value. Without a return value. This is the third scenario. This type of calling of a function is going to be existed. What is the last scenario we are having here means? What is the last scenario we are having means? Function without arguments and with arguments. Function with arguments and with return value. Function with arguments and return value. Function with arguments and return value. And here what is the, while defining the function, while declaring the function, we have indicated the return type as what? Int. And this function is going to return some value as integer. And what is the arguments list it is containing? It is containing first argument as integer and second argument as also what? Integer. And this type of scenario we are going to be called it as what? Function with arguments and with return value. Function with arguments and with return value. And here we are assigning the, we are collecting the A and B values from the main method. And we are passing the A and B values to the sum method. But in the previous program, we have been invoked directly. Sum method has been